What's up, internet? I am Manish from RebellionWriter.com and I am back once again with another Oracle Database AT&C tutorial. Today we will learn how to connect with pluggable database using sample user like HR through SQL developer in Oracle Database AT&C. If you love working on command line interface like me, then in the last tutorial we learned how to connect with pluggable database using SQL plus command line utility. If you want, you can watch that. Anyways, those who don't know what SQL Developer is, let me give you a quick intro. SQL Developer is a free graphic user interface developed and distributed by Oracle itself. You can use this software for almost all your Oracle database needs. I have done a dedicated video on how to install and use SQL Developer. You can find the link for that tutorial in the info card on your screen as well as in the description down below. Before starting this tutorial, I just want to say that in order to save time, we will be using the information and the TNS alias that we have already created in the Oracle Database AT&C tutorial number 2. I highly suggest you to watch that tutorial beforehand in order to better understand the concepts that we will learn today. That being said, let's not waste much time and start the tutorial. Once again, similar to SQL plus CLI, there are two ways of connecting with pluggable database in Oracle Database AT&C. First, the basic way, and the second, using TNS alias. Let's learn each of these starting with the basic method. Launch your SQL Developer if you haven't already and then come to this connection tab. If for some reason you can't see this connection tab on your screen, then go to the view menu and click connections. Once you have your connection tab, then click this big green plus button. This will open up a pop-up window for creating a new connection. Here we have to do the entire configuration. Let's do that. The first field is connection name. Here you have to give a name to your connection. You can name it whatever you want as it's completely user defined. I'll name my connection HR@18C. Fair enough, I guess. The second field is username. Here you have to specify the schema name through which you want to connect with your Oracle Database AT&C. Such as for this demonstration, I want to use the HR schema to connect with my database. Thus, in my case, the username will be HR. You can use whichever schema you want to connect with your database. It could be a sample schema like the HR or a user-defined schema. Please do not get confused between the words user or schema. In Oracle ecosystem, both these words are used as synonyms for each other. Anyways, let's move ahead. The next field is password. As the name suggests, in this field, you have to write the password of your schema with which you are connecting with your database. As I am trying to connect with my database using HR schema, thus I will specify the password for HR schema here. Great. Next, please check the save password checkbox. In case you want to specify any color for your connection, then you can use this drop down color selection panel. These four settings are the basic ones which will remain the same for both type of connections that we will be learning in this video. Now come to this Oracle section. As you can see, SQL Developer has already filled most of these fields with the default settings. Anyways, let's explore this section and see what necessary settings we need here in order to connect with our Oracle Database AT&C using a pluggable database. First thing which you will see in this section is connection type. It is a drop-down list. From this list, you need to select the first option, which is basic. Since right now we are learning the first way of connecting with a pluggable database, which is the basic way. Therefore, we selected basic as our connection type. The second thing is role. For this demonstration, we are using a sample schema, which is HR, to connect with our database. HR is a normal user. It doesn't have any high privilege role assigned to it. Thus, we will let the role stay set on default. Okay, now come to the next thing, hostname, which is a text field. In this text field, you need to write down the hostname of your machine. By default, it is set on localhost, and for the purpose of this demonstration, it's good, so I won't change it. Next text field is port. Here you have to specify the port number for your Oracle database. The default port number is 1521, which is already set here. For this demonstration, I'm good with this default port number also. Thus, I will not change it. Now you ask, Manish, I don't know the host name and the port number for my Oracle database AD&C. Where can I get this information? Well, that is a very good question. In Oracle database, all the network settings are saved into the listener.ora file. Thus, you can use it to get all your information. The location of the listener.ora file must be flashing on your screen. That being said, let's move ahead. Next field is SID. SID is a site identifier. It is a unique name for your database instance. In Oracle 10G or 11G, the most common name of database instance used to be ORCL, and we used to put that here, if you remember. Now, with the multi-tenant architecture, things have changed a little bit. SID seems to be losing its charm and services is slowly coming into the limelight. Thus, here we will not be choosing the SID, rather we'll be going with the service name. In order to establish a connection with database through a user in Oracle 18c, we need to specify the service name of the pluggable database into which that user is either created or placed. As for this demonstration, we are using HR user for making a connection. Thus, we will need to specify the service name of its native pluggable database. We already know that all our sample users like HR and OE are placed in our default pluggable database whose name is ORCLPDB, and its corresponding service name is also ORCLPDB. We will be using this information here. So, in the service name text field, we will write our service name, which is ORCLPDB. Done. That's all we have to do. Now, let's press the test button and see if we have successfully created our connection or not. Voila! Test status success. Now, just press the save button to save your connection. So, that is the basic way of connecting with a pluggable database in Oracle Database 18c. I know, it is slightly complicated. Suppose you have 20 users created in a pluggable database. In order to connect with your database using those 20 users, you will need to do all these settings individually 20 times for each of those schemas. That's definitely going to be a headache. Don't you think so? Anyways, now the question arises here. Don't we have any less complicated way? My dear friend, I have a good news for you. There is a very easy way, and that is to connect with your database using TNS alias. You can consider TNS alias as an envelope which contains all these settings which we just did under a single name. You can create a TNS alias for your pluggable database by creating an entry into your tnsnames.ora file. Take a look here. I have already created a TNS alias in this tnsnames.ora file. In this entry, I have set localhost as my host name, 1521 as the port number, and ORCLPDB as the service name for the pluggable database. I named this entry ORCLPDB after the name of the pluggable database into which all my sample schemas are placed. I have demonstrated how to create a TNS alias in detail in Oracle Database 18c tutorial number 2. I suggest you to watch that tutorial and create a TNS alias for your database instance right now. Anyways, let's get back to our SQL developer and see how to connect with a pluggable database using this TNS alias in Oracle Database 18c. Here we are. As you can see, the first three settings, which are connection name, username and password, will remain the same, so let's not change them. Don't forget to check this save password checkbox. Now come back to this Oracle section. This time we will not be doing all these settings individually, rather we will let the server do all the dirty work for us. Let's see how. Come to this connection type and change it from basic to TNS. As soon as you do that, things will change. See, that's what I was talking about. Anyways, let's move ahead. Next setting is role. Let it stay on default. Now let's come to the next setting, which is network alias. This is a drop-down list containing all the TNS aliases in it. If you have properly created a TNS entry in your tnsnames.aura file, then you must see the name of that entry in this list. Let's open it and see whether we have the name of our TNS entry into this list or not. And right at the bottom, we have orclpdb, which is our TNS alias. Let's select it. That's all we have to do to connect with a pluggable database using TNS alias in Oracle 18c. Let's press this test button and see if we have established a connection successfully or not. Connection status, success. Click Save button to save this connection for future use. That's how we create a connection to our pluggable database in Oracle Database 18c. Once you have successfully created and saved your connection, next you just have to connect with your database using it. Doing that will be pretty simple. Let me show you. But for that, we first need to close this new connection pop-up window. Now in the connection tab, you can see all your connections which you have created and saved. For example, we just created this HR@18c connection. Right? To connect with your database using this connection, you simply have to right-click on it and choose the first option, which is connect. That's all you have to do. Right now, we are connected to our Oracle database using the HR user. So, in this tutorial, we learned the two methods of connecting with pluggable database using SQL Developer. Hope you enjoyed watching and learned something new. Please comment and let me know how you like this video. Also, don't forget to like and share it on your social media. Most importantly, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. So, that's the tutorial on how to connect with your pluggable database using SQL Developer in Oracle Database 18c. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.